Morning, everyone. Hello. Thank you, Terry, for those kind words. Thank you for your passion, your conviction, your resilience, and the strength of your voice for Sault Ste. Marie. You have, from the very beginning, consistently stood up for this community and for the incredible people who live here. It has resonated not just throughout National Caucus, but throughout the government. We're lucky to have you on the team, but the Sioux is lucky to have you as well. Je suis aussi très heureux d'être en compagnie du ministre François-Philippe Champagne, qui est un autre champion infatigable des travailleurs et de l'environnement. Big shout out to Mayor Christian Provenzano. Great to have you here, a friend and strong partner for Northern Ontario, and of course for Mike McQuaid for welcoming us to Algoma this morning. It's so good to be back in the Sioux. Whenever I'm here in this beautiful city, I'm reminded that this is a place where no obstacle is too big and no opportunity is too small. Just think of when we came together and got unjustified tariffs on Canadian steel removed. Or the last 15 months, which saw neighbors supporting each other through a once-in-a-generation pandemic. When there's a job to be done, this city steps up to the plate to turn challenges into opportunities. And in today's world, I can't think of a better way to move forward. My friends, there's no doubt that climate change is the test of our generation. Canadians get that. That's why people voted for real climate action almost 2 years ago. But of course, it's not just about protecting our environment. It's about protecting jobs, too. After all, even if there are those who would try to say otherwise, fighting climate change and growing the economy must go hand in hand. Le Canada est bien placé pour être un chef de file et fournir au monde les innovations les plus propres et les plus efficaces, maintenant et pour les décennies à venir. C'est pourquoi nous nous sommes fixés l'objectif audacieux d'atteindre la carboneutralité d'ici 2050. Et la semaine dernière, nous avons fait de cet objectif une loi. Ceci donne aux Canadiens et aux entreprises la confiance qu'ils ont besoin pour continuer d'investir dans les innovations et les technologies propres. Ce cadre de responsabilisation et de transparence nous permet d'atteindre cet objectif d'une manière qui donne confiance aux Canadiens et qui donne aux entreprises et aux travailleurs les outils dont ils ont besoin pour réussir et rester compétitifs. Et c'est exactement pourquoi nous sommes ici aujourd'hui. Today, we're investing up to $420 million for Algoma Steel to make green retrofits in its operations and phase out coal-fired steelmaking processes. With new state-of-the-art equipment, Algoma Steel will transition to electric arc furnace production, giving them an even greater competitive edge over imported steel. That's not just good for business. That's good for the environment, too. This green transition will be the equivalent of taking over 900,000 cars off the road, as François-Philippe pointed out. That's a huge step for cutting pollution. It's not hard to see why industrial plants like Algoma Steel are seeing the opportunities of clean innovation and saying, I want in. And as they do, they're bringing workers along with them. With our investment in green retrofits, Algoma will create 500 well-paying jobs over the next 4 years, 450 new student co-op placements for the next generation of workers, and training for 75 high-skilled jobs in STEM. It just goes to show that by investing in Canadian know-how, we can create good jobs for today and tomorrow alike, from manufacturing the best steel in the world to mining the critical metals for our zero emissions future. Notre investissement veut dire que les travailleurs d'Algoma auront des emplois pour des décennies à venir. Ça donne la certitude pour les paiements hypothécaires. Ça donne confiance dans les plans d'épargne pour l'éducation des enfants. Évidemment, ça mène à moins de pollution et ça protège les côtes des Grands Lacs et les forêts du bouclier canadien. Good jobs, clean air, a strong economy, that's win, win, win. And today's announcement is just the start. Very soon, We'll have good news about another major investment, this time with ArcelorDefasco in Hamilton. I'll have more to say then, but the bottom line is this. Another iconic steelmaker will become more competitive and an even stronger partner in reducing emissions. Combined, these two projects alone have the potential to reduce our emissions by about 6 megatons a year, helping us reach our ambitious climate goals. For industry and for climate, we're getting results. Dans un sens, notre parcours vers un avenir carbone neutre commence à l'aciérie. L'acier fait partie des étapes essentielles à un avenir carbone neutre, des éoliennes au transport en commun en passant par les véhicules électriques. En ce qui concerne les véhicules électriques, nous avons annoncé la semaine dernière que 100% des ventes de voitures et de camions au Canada seront sans émissions d'ici 2035. La réduction de nos émissions liées au transport est l'une des voies les plus accessibles et les plus avantageuses sur le plan économique que nous pouvons prendre maintenant et jusqu'en 2050. Ce sont des investissements audacieux comme ceux-ci qui mènent à des mesures climatiques audacieuses. We're up against a real challenge when it comes to climate change, there's no doubt. But we also have a real opportunity, too. This is no time for old ways of thinking or skeptics that would tell us we have to choose between jobs or climate action. This is the moment to work together to build a clean future and a more resilient economy. In fact, people understand you can't have a real plan to strengthen our economy if you don't have a real plan to fight climate change. And that's what I'm focused on. Clean air, good middle-class jobs, and a brighter future for all our kids. And that's why it's such a pleasure to be here in the Sioux today. Merci beaucoup, mes amis. Thank you all.